Yes, the next chapter is normal distribution, and the first case in normal distribution is the probability density function of a normal variate is f of x equals to 1 by 5 into under root 2 pi into e raised to minus half into x minus 52 by 5 square. Now first of all, we need mean as well as standard deviation to calculate z-score, because z-score is the soul of normal distribution. Without z-score, we cannot calculate any type of probability in case of normal distribution. So to calculate z-score, first we have to recognize what is the value of mean as well as standard deviation for this particular data. Now compare these two functions, this theoretical function as well as this function given in the question. In the place of z, what has been given? X minus 52 divided by 5. Now we know that that is nothing but the z-score, and we know that z-score is x minus mean divided by standard deviation. So on the basis of this analysis of the data, we can say that in this particular data, mean is 52 and standard deviation is 5. No other data is useful for us. Only these two values are actually important. Now we can calculate the respective probabilities. And in the first instance, we require to calculate probability of x less than or equal to 46.5. Probability of x less than or equal to 46.5. Now to calculate z score, we want or we need any specific value of x. So first of all, let us take x equals to 46.5, exact 46.5. Now we can calculate z score for this particular value of x. Z equals to x minus mean divided by standard deviation. So z score will be 46.5 minus 52 divided by 5. Yes. It is negative 1.1, is it? Negative 1.1. That is z score for this. Now what? First of all, let us try to visualize the entire situation. This is a rough sketch of normal curve. It is from negative infinity to positive infinity. Yes, mind well, the normal curve never touches the x-axis. Exactly in the center, x takes value equal to the mean, that is 52. Now we have two signs. First, our z is negative. This is actually, say, left hand side area. For z with negative sign, this is the area, and for z with positive sign, this is the area. And it is matter of simple logic, when can z be negative? If x is less than the mean, z can be negative. Now this mean line or central line divides entire curve into two parts, first half and second half, left half, right half, anywhere it can be described. But total area of the entire curve is taken to be 1. These half values are less than mean and these half values are greater than mean. So 46.5 falls in this region. Say x 46.5 can be here. So at that particular point, z is 1.1 or say minus 1.1. Minus sign has no importance, but it is the sign that x is less than mean. Now take the table of normal areas. The table is in this type of pattern. Say 1.0. First is in that way. 0.0 and so on. Now what is 1.1? 1.1 comes to the first table. 1.1. Yes, 1.364. Here 1.1 and here 0. So 1.1 means 1.10. 0.3643. 0.3643. Now what is this 0.3643? This is the area between these two lines. Here Z is always 0 because X and mean are equal. So Z score is always 0 here. So this is called the area between Z0 and Z1.1 is 0.3643. Now the question is, what is the area of our interest? First of all, this is not area of our interest. We want X equals less than or equal to 46.5. This line indicates X 46.5 and further interest is on left hand side, because this is the area where X is less than 46.5 and we are interested in this area. Technically, in the table, all the areas are actually between this line and any line, either on left hand side or on right hand side. We cannot direct find the area for this particular part. Now, what to do? We know that the area of the entire left hand side is 0.5, from which we are not interested in this much area. So the remaining area is the area of our interest. That means probability of X less than or equal to 46.5 is nothing but 0.5, that is the area of the entire right and left hand side, minus 0.3643, the area of that part in which we are not interested, because in that part X is greater than 46.5, so we are not interested. Yes, remaining
is the
0.1357. This is the answer for X taking value 46 or less. Now the second part. In the second part, we need to calculate probability of 47 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 57. That means X can take any value between 47 and 57, both inclusive. Either 47 or more, but not more than 57. In this type of case, we have to calculate two values of Z scores. Say X1 equals to 47. That will give us Z score or Z1. 47 minus 52 divided by 5, that is minus 5 by 5, so Z1 comes to minus 1, that means 1.00. and let us take X2 as 57, that will give us Z2. 57 minus 52 divided by 5, that means positive 5 divided by 5, so Z2 comes to positive 1 or 1.00. Again, the sketch of normal curve. Now, first Z is negative 1. That means we have to take the value on left hand side area, or say X1 is 47, which is less than 52, so it falls in the left hand side area. Say here X is 47 and Z is minus 1. Similarly, the positive Z or x greater than mean can be on the right hand side. Stay here, and z is positive 1. We are interested in the value of x, which is between 47 and 57. That means this is our area of interest. In other words, x never takes value less than 47, so we are not interested in this part. Similarly, x never takes value greater than 57, and that's why we are not interested in this part. Now just, what is the area for z1 in the table?
0.3413.
That is for any one side only. Similarly, 0.3413 on this side. This area is nothing, it is probability of x taking particular value or value between mean and particular value. So probability of 47 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 57 is nothing but the addition of these two areas. What is this 0.3413? This 0.3413 on left hand side is the probability that x takes value between 47 and 52. Similarly, on the right hand side, this 0.3413 is the probability of x taking value between 52 and 57. So summation of these two is actually probability of x taking value 47 to 52 and 57 to 57. So ultimately we can say that probability of x taking value 47 to 57 is summation of these two. Yes, that is 0.6826. Yes, this is the final answer. And the third last is x greater than or equal to 45. Probability of x taking value greater than or equal to 45. Let us take x equals to 45, so z score will be 45 minus 52 divided by 5, that means minus 7 divided by 5, so z comes to minus 1.4 or 1.40. Again, the sketch or diagram. Now 55 is less than 52 or z is negative, so the line falls in the left hand side area. X can be 45 here. We are interested in x either exactly 45 or greater. Or greater means any value greater than 45, whether it is 52 or more. So ultimately we can conclude that x takes value from 45 to positive infinity. So entire diagram, the whole right hand side area and the part and partial of left hand side area are the areas of our interest. Now we know that this area is actually 0.5. Just find out the area for z 1.4 or area between z 0 and 1.4.
0.4192.
So our area of interest is summation of these two, and that means probability of x taking value 45 or more is 0.4192 from the left hand side and 0.5 from the right hand side. So ultimately the probability is 0.9192. Yes.